Okay, Barakatha Yahweh, Barakatha Yahweh Shai. All praises to Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, double honor to apostles and elders of Great Millstone. You know, Shalom to the elect. This is going to be a stiff admonishment of reality and of basically to admonish and give warning, because that's what the word admonish means. Means to give warning, okay, to the sincere Akim, you know, and what we're really into and how things can manifest if you're not playing along the guidelines. All right, so I just want to get a couple of scriptures first, then I'm going to go into the reason ultimately why I'm going into this. All right, so let me get this first. This is Romans chapter 15. This is Romans 15 and 14. And I myself also am persuaded of you, my brethren, that ye also are full of goodness, filled with all knowledge, able to admonish one another. Right? Because the scripture says what? The fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Excuse me. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. So when you have the fear of the Lord, then you're able to admonish. You're able to give warning. All right. Now, I have some other scriptures. This is a Sirach. Sirach chapter 13. Excuse me. Sorry, 19. We'll start at verse 13. It says, admonish a friend, it may be he hath not done it. And if he have done it, that he do it no more. So when you give admonishment, it's giving warning, because you may have done this before and got away with it. Or you can admonish a man and warn him from doing it. All right? And I'm gonna get into it. It says, admonish thy friend, it may be he hath not said it, because you're accounting for what words you speak as well. And if he have, that he speak it not again. And admonish a friend, for many times that it is a slander, and believe not every tale. There is one that slippeth in his speech, but not from his heart. And who is he that hath not offended with his tongue? Right? Because we've all offended with our tongue. We all went off with the tongue. Admonish thy neighbor before thou threaten him. And not being angry, give place to the law of the Most High. Right? Now, we're not saved by the law, but we are to keep the law, because the law, you breaking the law, us breaking the law, myself breaking the law, can bring judgment on you. You know, you may be of the elect, but that still can bring judgment on you. All right? And we're living in a time of judgment. The apostles who we believe to be the men who are set up by Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, coined this year the year of death, destruction, and deliverance. Sorry, diligence, excuse me. Lord willing, we be delivered. But the point is that this is the year of death, man. Last year was the year of the push. This is the year of death. Now, I'm just going to go into the story. There was a man in the camp. In a DC camp. I'm not sure what year he came around. All right. I came into the DC camp around 2011, 2012. All right. The camp was already established. Now, you had a man. His name was Kazakh. All right. Now, to make a long story short, Kazakh got into a a quarrel, if you will, on the streets. You know, it was some Jew rats or whatever. And they said that they said that he got that he threatened. That he threatened the Jew rats. And the Jew rats, they walked over and they told the police. And the police, you know, they arrested Kazakh. All right. So then after that, Kazakh, being in DC, everything is federal. So there's no state charges. Okay. So everything is taken seriously. So, with that being said, there was a case that was built up on terroristic threats, okay? So, moving forward, throughout the case, Kazakh, long story short, got delivered, you know? I'm not going to go into the details of the court case. For one, I wasn't there at the court case. For two, I don't, you know, that I wasn't a witness there, so I can't go into the details of it. However, I do know that he was delivered. And this is around the time when Apostle Gabbar was coming around, you know, the DC camp heavy. And during the time of Kazakh's deliverance, Apostle Gabbar told him to make a video to edify the brethren on your deliverance, showing the power of the Lord, giving the Lord Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai the glory. All right? Kazakh did not do that. Now I want to read this account in the scriptures, because at that time, I'll just fast forward a little bit. Well, I'll just fast forward now, and then I'll come back to another segment of this story. Kazakh was put to death. He was on a motorcycle accident. It was the day of Trayvon Martin's jury decision or judgment, and Trayvon Martin, what's the guy's name? Mark Zimmer, whatever. Zimmerman. I can't think his name right now. Zimmerman was walked off scot-free. That was the same day Kazakh was on a motorcycle accident. He was on a motorcycle, and the reports were that a minivan stopped short, and he basically, you know, the Most High ascended his body, man, you know, and jacked them all up, you know. Now, at the time when this all happened, I remember Apostle Gabbar was talking about it. He mentioned that, you know, he believed that, and other apostles and other elders said that they believed that he got put to death because he didn't make that video Apostle Gabbar told him to do. And at that time, I didn't believe that, in all honesty, until I read this account. Now, this is Acts chapter 12. Okay, I'm gonna just go straight to the point. Acts chapter 12, verse 20. And Herod was highly displeased with them of Tyre and Zidon, but they came with one accord to him, and having made Blastus, the king's chamberlain, their friend, desired peace because their country was nourished by the king's country. And upon a set day, Herod, arrayed in royal apparel, sat upon his throne, and made an oration unto them, meaning he gave a speech. And the people gave a shout, saying, it is the voice of a God and not of a man. And immediately the angel of Yahweh, Bashem Yahweh Shai, smote him because he gave not the Most High glory, and he was eaten of worms and gave up the spirit. So when I read that, it was like, damn, that has to be why. And to be all honest, that's just half the story. And another thing I want to mention too, this ain't my opinion. None of this of what I'm speaking is my opinion. None of this is what I'm speaking is what I'm feeling. This is actual factual. Everything that I'm speaking is based upon facts. Okay? Based upon facts, I'm going to bring out the scriptures on the situation. Things that correlate in the scriptures with this situation. Because mind you, remember, we're in the time of death, destruction, and diligence. Okay? So, moving forward, in the story, I also want to speak upon long story short, it was a high holy day. It had to be Purim. All right? It had to be Purim. Now, in Purim, during that time, because I remember it was right before the Passover, it was at the end of the year. And this is prior, of course, because at this time, Kazakh is alive. We were sitting, one brother was making the food, we were sitting, chilling, breaking bread. There's another brother that's in the camp of men of valor who was down here visiting. He's also a witness to this situation. Long story short, we were sitting there waiting on these brothers. It was Kazakh and two other men that are no longer in the camp. Long story short, we were waiting, and then we get a phone call. And it's these two other guys that are no longer in the camp. They're supposed to be coming down to meet us while, you know, to congregate with Akim at the camp. And damn. So they on the phone. I don't know exactly which one it was. They tell another brother in the camp that we already congregating with that. Yo, we got into a car accident. It was something like, I forget the exact details. I think they said it was an Edomite bitch that cut them off. They got into a car accident. And mind you, it's a high holy day. We get the news like, what the fuck? Like, the fuck? So brothers is upset. So we sitting there congregating. The fuck, you know, brother's upset, brother's mad. Then we hear this banging on the door, like boom, 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 boom. You know, we in the brother's house. The brother's like, what the fuck? So we hop up, go open the door, and nobody's there. So we go sit back, sit down, give like a minute or two or whatever the case is. Mind you, it's like 2013, so the story's gonna be vague in my mind. It said boom, 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 boom. So we hear banging again. So this time we hop up, run. Like, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck is going on? Somebody playing? Mind you, we already upset. Brothers got into an accident, this, that, and the third. And we like, what the fuck? So then it happened a third time. And then one of the head brothers of the camp said, whoa, whoa, he said, hold on, don't do nothing. You know? We just fell back. We sat down. And then he went to the door and looked. Nobody was there. Then, like, I don't know, man. Less than 5 minutes after that, you get a knock. And it's Kazakh and these two other dudes. And they walk in. They walk in and they're laughing. Like, ah, we got y'all. We got y'all. So we looking like, you know, be honest with you, brothers is kind of upset. Like, yo, why the fuck you playing like this? It's a holy day, you know? And they like, nah, it's not that serious. It's not that serious. It's not that serious. And brother's like, yo, man, yo, you can't be playing like that. You can't be playing like that, man. And another brother said, yo, what the fuck? He was serious. He was like, yo, what the fuck? What the fuck is wrong with y'all? What the fuck is wrong with y'all? Y'all can't be playing like that. Y'all can't be playing like that. And Kazakh says, nah, it's not that serious. It's not that serious. And another one of the dudes that's not in the camp no more, he says, he's making excuses too. I'm not going to get into the details of what he said. He starts making excuses too. And the one brother that was upset at them said, yo, you can't play like that. You can't play like that. I put curses up on the people that did that shit. That's how serious this truth is, man. You know? That's how serious the play spirit, that shit is dead. The presumptuous spirit, that's another thing, man. I want to get the scriptures on that, man, because the scriptures, because ultimately that's what it boils down to, man. Brother's saying something to you, you need to be fucking listening. Apostles, the elders, they saying what they saying, you need to be fucking listening. And it's like the Spirit of the Lord wants this video to come out now because of the time that we're living in. And I mentioned in the video prior that this is the season of the Passover. Yahweh Bashim Yahushua is not playing. Tazama was already an example, man. This is not time for play, man. A lot of people, you know, I'm just speaking as a man, you know. I've been around for a little bit. And we've seen things happen. And to understand that this truth ain't no joke. We talking about the words of the Yahweh Bashim Yahusha. That's why the scripture says what? Knowing the terror of the Lord, we persuade men. All right, I just want to get this scripture real quick. I got to get that scripture. I want to look up that word persuade. All right. All right, this is 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and 11. It says, knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahusha, we persuade men, but we are made manifest unto the Most High, and I trust also are made manifest in your consciousness, meaning to wake you the hell up, man. All right? The word persuade is persuade to induce one by words to believe, to make friends, to win one's favor, to gain one's goodwill, or to seek to win one, strive to please one, to tranquilize, to persuade unto, i.e. move or induce one to persuasion to do something. Right, and the persuasion is what? For brothers to get right and really take this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding very seriously. All right? So I'm just going to get this scripture as well. I'm going to bring the law out on it. This is Deuteronomy chapter 17. I'm going to start at verse 8. If there arise a matter too hard for thee in judgment, between blood and blood, between plea and plea, and between stroke and stroke, being matters of controversy within thy gates, then shalt thou arise and get thee up into the place which Yahweh thy power shall choose. And thou shalt come unto the priests, the Levites, and we're up under the order of Melchizedek and not up under the order of Aaron. So right now, when there's a matter, there's a strife, or who do we go to? We go to the apostles and the elders, man. All right, of great millstone, man. Those are the top men on earth right now, man. Or if the matter's not that hard, you go to your camp head. If the matter's not that hard, you go to a brother that's above you. This ain't rocket science. All right? Continuing on, it says, and thou shalt come unto the priests, the Levites, right? and unto the judge that shall be in those days, and inquire, and they shall show thee the sentence of judgment, and thou shalt do according to the sentence which they that of that place which Yahweh shall choose shall show thee, and thou shalt observe to do according to all that they inform thee, according to the sentence of the law, Look, the whole book is the law. The law, ultimately, in this segment, was to give Yahweh Bashim Yahushua the glory. The law is really to humble yourself when brothers is telling you something. Scripture says what? When in a matter of two or three witnesses, every word shall be established, man. Here goes verse 6. Deuteronomy 17 and 6. At the mouth of two witnesses or three witnesses shall he that is worthy of death be put to death, but the mouth of one witness he shall not be put to death. And that's the point, man. Because two or three witnesses, that's why Yahweh Shai, he reiterated this. He said, two or three gathered in my name, there I am in the midst. So one brother telling you something, and the two brothers telling you something, three brothers telling you something, you're supposed to take heed to it. Lest you fall into the category of being presumptuous, is what I'm going to keep reading. I'm going to jump to verse 10. And thou shalt do according to the sentence which that they of that place which Yahweh shall choose shall show thee, that thou shalt observe to do according to all that they inform thee. Okay, on the margin, I got 10, 1, instruct. The word is instruct there. So whatever you're instructed to do, you're supposed to do. I.e., you know, go hard for this truth, man. Give diligence. Scripture says what? I'd rather you that were cold or hot. If you are lukewarm, then I spew thee out of my mouth. And that word spew, when you look it up, it means to vomit. That means you're once a part of the body, then the body has no longer use for you. Your ailment to the body, and he's going to spit you out. He's going to spew you out. He's going to throw you up. You're going to be no longer a part of the body if you don't give diligence, if you don't hearken to the words of the Lord. All right? It says, according to the sentence of the Lord, which they shall teach thee, and according to judgment, which they shall tell thee, thou shalt do. Thou shalt not decline from the sentence which they shall show thee. To the right hand, nor to the left. So whatever he said, don't make your own way about it. Well, I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to do it that way. You know, I know he said to do it this way, but I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to do it that way. You're supposed to do exactly what you was told to do, man. All right? Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is not persuasive. You know? He's not. Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is straightforward. He's not forward. He's not crooked. He's straightforward. When he says to do, that's what he's supposed to do. And he ain't telling, he ain't whispering in your ear. He set up men to tell you what to do. Continuing on. And the man that will do presumptuously. I'm going to look this word up. Man, we into words. If you don't like it, change the channel. Verse 12. And the man that will do presumptuously, okay, the word presumptuously is zadawan, pride, insolence, presumptuous, arrogance, okay? I want to look at this word insolence real quick. It says rude and disrespectful behavior. Right. When you're rude and disrespectful, you say, I don't need to do it the way you said to do it. I'm going to do it my way. And let's see how far that gets. You know, look up the story of Dathan, Kori, and Abiram when they bucked up to the men of the Lord. Okay. Continuing on. It says, and will not hearken unto the priest that standeth to minister there before Yahweh thy power, or unto the judge, even that man shall die. And thou shalt put away the evil from Israel. And all the people shall hear and fear and do no more presumptuously. Amen. I mentioned in the video that we did on the live, myself, Yashawamba, and the brother Barak Kabar, about how you had different examples of the excess. If you're just an excess, you're holding back progress of Yasha Allah. You're holding back Kwame Yasha Allah. You can yell Kwame Yasha Allah all you want, but if you ain't helping build and rise Yasha Allah, then Yahweh Bashim Yasha is going to trim you off, man. You know? And the scriptures is plain, man. You know, with that, all praises to Yahweh Bashim Yasha, double honors to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone. You know, whatever we do, you know, wherever we set our heart to, you know, wherever we set our hand to, do it all thy might, like the scriptures say, man. You know, with that, all praise to Yahweh Bashim Yasha, double honors to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Shalom to the elect.